Hi, this presentation is going to examine the component growth model technique. In another presentation, we looked at simple growth models, which are based on a single growth rate. Component methods are different because they are based on three different rates calculated separately, those for birth, death, and migration. So the component method is based on the fundamental equation in demography as shown here. The first component method we'll review is the survival method, and this one is based entirely on natural increase, and that means it does not address any of the migration dynamics for a population, so it assumes that there's a closed population. And it is set up similarly to a life table by breaking the population down into different age and sex specific subpopulations, and then calculating interval estimates for each one. So here we've got the different age intervals. We've got male and female separated out. We've got survival rates. We have age-specific fertility rates, which you can see comes in only a few categories, assuming that there's only fertility between the ages of 15 and 49. And then over here, we've got estimated population. So for males and for females, calculated separately for each of the different age intervals. Other component methods do make use of migration. Those include the components to method, the administrative method, and the ratio correlation method. And this is an example of a component method that makes use of regions and states instead of, you know, the age and sex specific subpopulations. So this is a more spatially oriented method. And what you see here, we've got 2013 population, we have the total United States population, we have it broken out by region, we have it broken out by state, we have total population change, we have births, we have deaths, we have both international migration and domestic migration, which is important for looking at changes between regions. As you can see here, the Northeast has lost the most, while the South has gained the most for this time period. And then from that, we're able to estimate 2014 population size for each of these spatial units, the United States as a whole, the different regions, and the different states. So in summary, the component method projections treat births, deaths, and migration rates separately. As we saw, some of the methods actually did not incorporate migration into the calculations, whereas the simple growth approach uses a single growth rate. This component method incorporates both stocks, which is the number of people, and flows, the vital events of the fundamental equation. Thanks for watching.